Alright guys, so Jared doesn't know I'm actually filming this part, so basically, what would you guys think if me and Jared did like a little Q&A kind of thing, just like for fun? Not really generated towards the music or anything. If you guys want to do it about our lives or anything, that'd be pretty fun, right? It can be also music as well. You guys can ask anything. But yeah, just small idea. Maybe in the next episode.
Greetings and salutations. How the hell y'all doing? What's poppin'? We back on here on the tune-up. Got my dude Erick back in the mix. How you doing,
homie? Doing great, man. Yeah. I'm excited too. It's been a while, so.
It really has. You know, the last time we saw you, we was closing the doors on the TOP saga, which was crazy. You know Vessel has 13,000 views?
Jeez. Wait, guys, Vessel?
Yes.
Oh my God, I didn't even see that.
Yes, jeez. Bro. 13,000. Wow.
Didn't I say that was my favorite album out of all of them?
I think you did say that was your favorite one, yeah. That one has 13,000. Regional just cracked 5,000. And then self-titled is about to crack 9,000. So, like...
All right.
It's wild,
these T.O.P.
right?
fans, yeah.
Man, nah, and it's all for you. Check this out, y'all. We about to do the new release from Halsey. Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. I always forget the name of it because... Badlands was just so right to the point.
Oh, of course.
You know, it was boom, that's what it's called. And I was like, damn, okay, she got a new album. Oh, my bad. I know you get jump scares. My bad.
Like, I reacted late to it.
I remember when she was dropping the album, I could never remember the name. And that's not to say, like, the album is insignificant in any way.
Oh, of course.
I was just like, damn, what's the name of the album? Because I know she dropped something new. People have told me this album is dope. I've heard a lot of stuff about it in comparison to like Melodrama, which I'm also gonna do. They're saying that Halsey did it again. They're saying that Halsey killing it. They're saying that it's broad, it's different than Badlands, which is good. Have you heard anything about it?
Oh, dude, this album? No, but Badlands, when it first came out, I can still recite you all the songs in the album.
Man.
No joke.
Like, I was on Castle before everybody else was, and before it was the trailer for the Huntsman movie and everything.
Oh, of course.
You know, I thought Control was crazy, Colors was crazy.
Control was Color, Gasoline, New Americana, everybody.
Yeah, everybody
knows those songs.
And then, of course, Ghost. I mean, everybody Ghost. Knows Ghost. Like, yeah. That was her big song.
So many.
No, but you also got to see her in concert.
Oh, yeah, I did. Late 2015 at the Fonda, and like,
ooh.
You know, like when she didn't even have like a big name, like she was still kind of small, and yeah. I was like, oh, like who is this? You know, her tickets aren't that expensive, you know,
right.
Like $25. I'm like, let me see it, you know. And then I went and I was like, dang, she got presents.
Go ahead, yeah. She and a whole bunch of other people are on my I need to see list, but I say we just jump into the album.
Oh, of course,
I'm ready. This is the new release from Miss Halsey, Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. Number one, the prologue.
I feel like I'm rolling.
Two households,
right?
Both alike in dignity.
Game of Thrones shit, man.
From forth the fatal loins of these two foes,
fatal
a pair
loins?
Of star-crossed what? Lovers take their life. His misadventure, piteous overthrows, do with their death,
the
bury
shit?
Their parents' strife.
Ooh.
The fearful...
That's a vibe. Nice little intro to the album. I'm intrigued.
I like that. I love the story. I got tingles on that storyline.
Number two, 100 letters. The jungle type feel. Ooh.
Damn, Tarzan getting
ooh,
up in
yeah.
there.
He said one day I'd realize why I don't have any friends.
Ooh.
I find myself alone at night, unless I'm having sex. I said I've got something to butter up and taste when you get bored.
Okay, a little atmospheric guitar in the back, that's crazy.
Driving down like Sunset Boulevard.
Yeah, something to turn your day around.
You know?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Easy. I said I'm not something to butter up and taste when you get bored. Cause I have to find some peace and quiet.
hard. Oh, damn.
I know. She's bringing it for the first time. Right?
Oh, hell yeah. Halsey, yo. Salute to you. Round of applause for the lady known as Halsey. Alright, number three, Eyes Closed. I've actually heard this one. This was one of the drops when the album came out. I wonder if it was the second single to follow Now or Never. But Erick hasn't heard this, so
no.
We're going to react to it together. Like, it's going to be my second reaction, third reaction. I don't know how many times I listened to the song, because I like this song, but it'll be his initial reaction. So,
definitely.
A little bit of a
definitely
switch up on the tune up. Ooh.
Oh, okay.
Ooh.
I'm ready for it. Just saying it right now. Any instrumental?
Yeah.
I love it. Album, I think the lead single for the album as well. If you haven't heard this, it's a little bit of it for you. Okay, now I know why. I know why. This kind of reminds me a little bit of Blackberry.
Yeah, no. If you don't know Blackberry, you gotta look that dude up. Fire.
Calling it now. Blackberry and Halsey.
They need to collab. If y'all ever see this, make it happen. That would be dope as hell. That would be crazy. Number 7. Sorry. Bit of a detour.
Okay, yeah. I've missed your calls for months, it seems. Don't realize how mean I can be. Cause I can change my mind each day. I didn't mean to try you on, but I still know your birthday and your mother's favorite song. So I'm sorry to my unknown lover that anybody ever really starts to fall in. She's speaking to like future boyfriends and yeah, the one she just, you know, ended it with.
Yeah, like it's a trippy type of concept for the song. Like it's both present and out of body. Like that's crazy. That's crazy.
That's a powerful track. I'm not even gonna lie. Yeah, I wanna soak it all in.
Yeah, yeah. That's that song on the track. That's the track that you can sit back to and just, you know, reflect on.
Seriously. It is like,
this song got me thinking about all the people I've done wrong in my life. Like, hey, to y'all, I'm sorry too, bro. Like, if I rubbed you wrong in any way, shape, or form, this song is to you.
I feel like this is like the type of person that knows they're messed up inside and they just want to say sorry to you in like the most sincere way, but just can't face it up to it.
For those conversations that I can't do in person,
exactly.
Is this song.
Here's this song.
Fire. Absolute fire.
Love it.
Alone still has the highest ranking on the album by far, but that one is hard. That one's hitting hard. Number 8, halfway through the album.
I love this title right here.
The title crazy, right?
Okay.
Number 8, Good Morning. And it's like, I think it's an interlude, so she might be updating the story of the album, but let's see what's going on.
All right. Tell
me once, there was a place where love conquers all. A city where the streets flow with milk and honey. I haven't found it yet, but I'm still searching. The shores bend and break for her, and she begs to be loved. But nothing here is as it seems. Nothing here is as it seems. Sun's coming up a while.
Sun's coming up a while. Like the updated version of Goosebumps introduction.
Seriously though, it does really sound like Goosebumps.
Yeah, right.
Number 9, live featuring Quavo of the Migos. Breakfast is cold as our bed. I'm watching you choke down the words that you say. I'll watch you devour, mistake me for bread. Or boy, is you fed? Or are you misled? Or you turning red? Cause I'm trying to get the impression that I get the message you wish I was dead. Damn! Epic
as
hell.
Savage on this.
Hell yeah.
Oh my god.
Completely just went off the rails. Straight at your neck, boy. Coming at you, boy. Ain't no feelings here, B. I heard what you said. What she said. You talk about your head game. I know that it's fire flame. Your mouth make a hurricane. You notice that we in love. Treat her right and she won't complain. Bring back the time. Treat her right and she won't complain. I mean, it's simple logic, but yeah. What you gonna die for when everything you told lies? What you gonna die for when everything you told is lies? Like, what leg do you have to stand on? Like,
that platform?
Gone. Done. It don't matter what you put Quavo on, he just kills it. Number 10, Walls Could Talk. Damn, string sample killing it. A. What? Ooh, that medieval like. Okay, hold up. Wait a fucking minute. Wait a minute. She took us to the medieval feast just now with that shit.
Oh my gosh.
You know, like, she had the orchestra come in and get everybody in their seats, and then the fucking royal family arrived, and then, like, the Capulets came through, and they was like, play the goddamn music, and then the shit just dropped. That shit is crazy. Wow.
What a way to close.
Too short. Nah.
Oh, man.
Nah. That's a crime. I'm gonna need like a 4-minute version of that song. I'm so upset right now.
One third of the way through when it started changing to all those beats. Oh my gosh.
That's a crime. That song needed to be like 3 minutes longer. That's not fair.
I was ready for it too.
That change up.
This and Alone right now.
I'm saying, holy shit, what a song. That's a banger. I don't care what nobody said. That shit went so hard just now. Like, I'm so shook. Like,
I'm ready to just hear it twice again, so I don't know about you.
Honestly, let's just run this shit back. Like, for real. Just the way that they first switched up right here. Bring it to the royal feast. That shit is insane. That is fucking crazy, bro. Are you serious right now? That's absolute fire. I'm so mad it's so short, but that shit is crazy. Number 11, Bad at Love. Hey. Whoa. Say what? No way. Go ahead, build it out. Got a girl with California eyes, and I thought that she could really be the one this time. I always think about it when I'm driving through. I believe that I'm in too deep. Always make the same mistakes. Yeah. Absolute fire, inferno, furnace, whatever other adjective for fire, man. This shit is crazy.
Walls could talk, I'm still
shook over that too. Like, no, disrespect. No, we not downplaying Bad at Love at all, but Walls Could Talk. Honestly. That shit's too crazy. It's too fucking crazy. It's too good. Alright, let's continue. I'm never ready for that drop. That shit is crazy. But anyways, let's continue with the album.
Don't play around, bro.
I'm trying not to play, but that's all I can really do when songs are that good. So, let's keep it going. Number 12, Don't Play.
Okay.
Music Box Swag. Ooh. Ooh. Hey. Hey. All alone. Woo! In the central bay, looking as fine as it's been all day. Everybody thirsty, drinks on me. Put a little clothes on me, oh man. Trying to take back what you said on me. I'm on my own. I had so much space to be. I'm moving on. It's getting don't play with me. I'm so shook. That shit. It's like Walk the Talk Part 2, bro. Motherfucker, don't. That's hard as hell. Okay. What you doing, baby? Right. Right.
A remix on this real quick.
That shit is crazy. That's crazy. Shook. Absolute monster bangers. Number 13, Strangers featuring Lauren Jarigui.
That's like the French version of Jaguar? Yeah,
probably. I don't know. If we're butchering your name, baby girl, I'm very, very sorry. Take them back to the 80s right now. We take them back to the 80s right now. Okay, come on. It's never been, this is fine.
There's been like some songs that I just, what did I just experience?
Honestly. if y'all have been paying attention, that Don't Play, that Alone, that Walls Could Talk.
Bruh.
Number 15, Devil and Me.
You say I would hit the ceiling.
Classic Halsey right here.
Hell yeah. This definitely feels like Room 93 type shit. Yes. We've come to the final track.
Boom.
Number 16, Hopeless. In reference to the name of the album, featuring the almighty Cashmere Cat.
Why you make it look so easy?
Okay.
Promise that I'm gonna call you back in five.
Boy, you make Halsey it look too. So
simple. Yeah, this is definitely Badlands type. Yeah, but the last one definitely felt like Room 93, and then this one feels like Badlands. This is crazy.
Cause you know the truth hurts, the secrets kill. Can I think and then I love it
Cause you know the truth hurts and secrets kill. I can't stress to y'all how true that shit is. If that's not career-defining lyrics, if that's not life-defining lyricism, like, I don't know what the hell is. Oh my god, like, she did that.
I'm going to the next concert. I'm taking my girl. Let's go.
I gotta go. I've never seen her, but best believe I'm gonna try. Let's keep the song going.
Cause you know the good that you're on, but so did this, and so it must be better than I think it is.
Wow.
Good die young and so did this.
And then this beautiful Cashmere Cat production.
Me on the radio and turning down off. Packing up the way you make me.
This is such a powerful moment. And it's perfect in the album too.
Think it must be better than I think it is. Give me those assets, it's easy to forgive.
Yeah, Halsey, you did that.
Wow.
Holy shit, man.
Way to close it.
I'm so on my feels right now, but like, wow, bro. That's probably one of the most quality albums to come out this year.
Yeah, I think so. Like, every single song.
That's what I'm saying. Every single song was incredible. I can't even say the statement of, oh, some songs were better than others. Like,
no.
I can't say that. Like, everything on here was dope as hell. Oh my god. Alright, let's do the after album talk.
Let's do it. We're in the after album.
Exactly, yeah. Let's wrap this shit up, bro. Wrap it up then. Final thoughts on Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. Your girl Halsey did that. That shit. Wow. I'm dead serious when I say this. That's one of the best albums this year.
Yeah.
Sid's album was fantastic. Heilani's album was great. Khalid's album was great. Like, there's been a lot of great works that came out this year, but I definitely now have to put Hopeless Fountain Kingdom in that conversation because the quality of the musicality on this album is what's really just shocking to me, but not shocking in the sense that I didn't expect it, but shocking that it's just so damn good. Like, what the hell? Like, this is... I'm speechless how good it is. Like, I can't get it out.
I literally thought, because I knew how good Badlands was, I was like, I don't know if Halsey's gonna kill it with a new album, you know?
Yeah.
Because people, you know, they go drastic changes from first to second.
And people love to do comparisons to the first album. Like, everyone, oh, well, Badlands forever. I'm like, well, we gotta move on.
I love Badlands. Don't get me wrong.
Same. It's very similar to Bryson Tiller's phenomenal project that came out this year. It's very similar to the conversation I was having about that with my other homie on the show. Shout out to Renzan. He asked me Trap Soul, The True to Self, which is the two albums he's put out. And I was like, that's very hard to say because they're two different albums. This is a completely different album from Badlands. Like, Badlands was very, like, turmoil, anguish, and honesty.
Of course.
This is more narrative, expressive, and...
just a whole new ballpark in terms of... where she took her alternative.
Yeah, it was like she broke through the stratosphere with this album. You know what I mean? Like, it was like a creative breakthrough. Not to say that Badlands wasn't creative, but I definitely feel like she was in a different light and in a different mindset going into the writing of this album. She's always been a great writer, but I feel like she pushed herself beyond limits on this album. And that's not to say that she didn't go all the way hard on Badlands, but it's more apparent for me on this release. I think this effort is definitely... I think it's stronger than Badlands. I think it'll leave more of an impression than Badlands did for me, because I loved Badlands, but I definitely know I'll go back to this one more than I go back to Badlands. Because I still go to songs from that album, but I definitely think I'm gonna run this one start to finish more than I did Badlands. You know what I mean?
Definitely. Every single song, just
If I had to choose to just pick one entire album,
yeah, this is it. Not only was it captivating, but it was engaging. It mm-hmm. was fun. It was energetic. It was
even some R&B in there. Yeah, it feels so like it was hinge. Oh.
It was versatile. It was diverse, and it was genuine. Like her vocals, like you can't sleep on her vocals. But
yeah. We got Quavo,
Cashmere Cat, Lauren from Fifth Harmony, like. Harmony. It's a small guest list, but it all worked out because they all added to the overall impact of the album. And I mean, I love when artists go all the way in, and I love when artists give themselves to their music. And you can definitely tell that this was the one that she dove headfirst in and went completely all the way hard for it. Like, this album meant something to her. And again, I have to backpedal once again. Not to say that Badlands didn't mean anything to her. I just feel that in this new realm of life that she's in and this new era of her career, mm-hmm. she's shining more than ever. Like,
oh, of course,
this is a career defining album. If I have be blunt, like, we'll remember Badlands and we'll definitely remember Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. Like, she's on such a great track right now that the expectations are gonna be high for the third album.
Oh, no, of course,
but she's got the caliber to be consistent with her music, so I have nothing but support and love for Halsey.
I'm ready for it. I mean, exactly. I know this one just came out earlier this year, but it's just like, I'm ready for album 3.
Exactly. Now I got 2 great projects to bump by you. And that's just the makings of a great artist. When you can give me more than just great songs. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. artists give you great songs, but great artists give you great albums and great material and just greatness upon that. So,
of course.
Like I said, this is a career-defining album. Halsey, you did that. That was phenomenal. And thank you for one of the most fun listens I've ever had on the show. Like, by far. Like, I'm going to be talking about this for a while. And, you know, I've been trying to catch up with all the releases, but I'm happy that I waited for this one because this one is a special one. So, mm-hmm. once again, shout out to Halsey. Shout out to everybody that wanted this episode. And we hope you enjoyed it because we enjoyed listening to it.
Oh, yeah.
That's going to do it for this episode of The Tune Up. I want to say thank you once again to my boy Eric for coming through.
Thank you for always having me, dude. Of course. You don't even know.
You already know. You almost had 100 subscribers, by the way.
Oh, my gosh. No, dude, I have not kept up.
Follow him on all of his socials. You can follow me on any and everything. Like, share, subscribe, the whole nine. Is there anything else you want to say?
You know what, guys? Just thank you guys so much for just wanting me to be here. Like,
exactly.
That's the reason why I keep coming back, to be honest. Not mainly just because I want to see Jared, but because, you know, I truly do enjoy the support, you guys. I do read the comments, and Jared always keeps me updated, too. And, you know, it's so fun. I just still can't believe it because, you know, I'm not really used to that kind of popularity, even though it's so subtle.
Mm-hmm.
I just thank you.
I mean, see the genuine. Look at him. Appreciating shit. Look at you. Thank y'all so much for everything y'all do for the both of us. You know, without y'all, there's no show. Without y'all, there's nothing moving. So we appreciate y'all 100%. Thank you for watching. I'm Jared. That's Eric. And we out of here. Bruh.